More pressure now that can be added to the tower here, specifically in the top lane too. Cinderin's going to be able to move it in. They got double range creeps and a ballista to work with.
Ake.
Ake has shown himself and is going to get trapped on the other side by Yapzor. A big pullback, and now he is doomed. Coddle has tied for fastest move speed in the game, but he doesn't have any boots or anything to help him get away from that one, and will be going down and be the first blood of the game.
And, I bet he requests that quelling bleeding.
Bank left here, hoping to come up and behind to see if they can make a move for Quakefa, who is going to show himself in the lane now. Here comes trouble. Bulldog could set up with the Roar, and they could just easily finger and finish things off. There's the Roar. There's the stun. There's the finger. Quakefa is going to be dead, but they have a rotation power, including Kezu and his Ravage. He wants to dish it off, but they're going to get the first takedown, which will be Bulldog. A one-for-one split, while up and above, EGM is going to be able to get off the Hex and kind of separate himself from Era a bit, while Era continues to move in, waiting for the...
Oh, EGM has Blink?
That's what I said. Oh, yeah. He had a quick Blink.
Yeah, he's ready.
Yeah.
Now they're going to get ready on the... They need BOTs, though. I don't think they can do this without the... Oh, actually, they have Finger.
And a charged up blast.
Boom!
See you later. Boom! Don't suspect the behind the back play from your keeper of the light. Very nicely done. And with that, be able to pick up a nice little. And the Yapzor can't get close enough to kind of follow it up with a telekinesis or anything.
People Loda coming in from behind. He is going to find one of the weak supports. Looks like Yapzor will be the target.
Ah, they got him. EGM's able to blink in. They get the setup. Cold Embrace keeps him alive for the meantime, but Loda might be able to chunk through the ice and be able to finish off that little Yapzor. And the follow-up play as they get Quakefa. Beautiful. Roar and finger. Lots of hate for the Death Prophet.
This is very similar to the other game, which was last game, in that they just completely dodge type. They don't want to use it on one or two heroes, but it's getting to that point where maybe you should just blink solo Ravage Align, because sooner or later it's going to be daytime.
Oh, top lane. Looks like a jump for Era here by EGM. Gets the stun. And now Era is going to get fingered down and taken apart before an opportunity to even get an Omni Slash off if he'd like. So Era goes down. At the same moment, Ake's picked up a gem, so that together with the Ags as the daylight will end will allow the timing might be off. I mean, Loda had just picked up his BKB now, and based on the approach that they make, it could be left to be desired here by Escape if they don't get a good start. And there's going to be the jump. There's the gush. They're looking to go for Ake. Ake gets the blinding light off, but now they'll be able to focus him down. Both supports will be dropped here.
They lost
while Loda makes a go for Cinderin. Cinderin gets the cold embrace, but Loda's determined to get the finish there. Will be able to do it. Goes into Shadow Dance, looks to sidestep. Bulldog makes his approach, and they're able to get the Yapzor down. Hezu catches both S4 and Bulldog with the Ravage, but they're able to shrug that one off, go for the Watermelon Man, and be able to slice him up and platter him up for a future picnic. But nonetheless, Loda with a triple kill. And that was Escape making the approach in the initiative.
It'll escape our fighting.
Is it damage on heroes?
Yeah, it's done to heroes.
Okay. Like, I mean, I know he's blasting the hell out of creeps. I don't know if that's a factor or not, but yeah, look at him go. And now daytime even. They'll be able to have that unobstructed vision. They quickly take out Yapzor with the finger. Beautiful blinding light blast will put Quakefa into enemy territory, and they take him out fast. He will have a buyback if necessary, but if he has to use it now, then you know Escape. Things are not going so well. Tier 3's dead. Steps off, goes for Kazu as he gets mana leak. There's going to be the blast right into Escape here. And they're feeling determined to kind of move on four. Era dishes out the Blade Fury. S4 does sidestep. Now Loda could be in a bit of trouble here. They get the telekinesis. They'll get the kill. And a blast is going to be on through. Era very low. There's going to be the cold embrace. We'll keep him alive. And Escape continue to truck in. And S4 says we got to go. Oh, canceled out. Nice stolen roar from Yapzor. We'll lock him in his place. The follow-up Ravage will be there. But the damage, is it available? They're eating a lot. And S4 will be able to jump away. Almost being able to get the catch. It's Loda for the Rubick, and they're not done yet. Boom, finger connection, Winter's Curse turnaround is going to be too late to save the Quakefa Death Prophet, and S4 is back and just as mighty. He looks to go, finds Kazu. It looks like they'll be able to slash him down, and it's a double kill for S4. Unfortunately, it looks like for Escape, Alliance will take another strong fight here as it turns into a 3-for-1 trade, but the net worth exchange is better for Escape. Take a fight while the Aegis is down. Loda finishes off the racks. We'll have to pop his BKB to make it out safely, and EGM's already kind of starting things down this mid lane. It's over. Okay. It looks like Escape Gaming have recognized that their backs are too far against the wall, and there's really no opening, and with the way the game was going, Alliance just continued to just build up and bulk up and bulk up while Escape can't even get out the front door to find any sort of farm, and that's just Alliance, man. They wring them out dry, and congratulations to them. Alliance will be moving on.